Hey Virgo, thank you for joining me for this message. I hope that you all are able to resonate with it. I put a few readings over on the other channel, Passed on Loved Ones channel. I'll put that information in the comment section for you to click on the link. All right, the next person coming into your life. The next person coming into Virgo's life, please. I have celebration. I have generosity. Person is very generous, okay, very generous, career driven, very traditional. They are the kind of person that likes to make memories, put things on film, take a lot of pictures. Person who saves a lot of things, follows family tradition, deeply rooted family traditions. Family means everything to this person. Like, this person is a healer, okay? It could be in the medical profession, but honestly, I just feel like this person is in your life to heal you from heartache and pain, things that you've been going through, something that you've been insecure about in your life. It could be some family struggles here that you have been insecure about. I feel like this person is here to clear up some things. This could be somebody coming back into your life that you've already known. You spent a lot of long time apart from this person, separated from him or her, and they're coming back for some sort of family tradition. They could be coming in for the holidays, Thanksgiving and Christmas. I feel like there's some healing needs to be here. You possibly didn't see this person or haven't seen this person since a loved one passed away and they just disappeared. They just left. All right. I feel like this person hasn't been around for a while, around the family. They felt insecure. They felt like they were being treated wrong or talked about wrong. I feel like this is somebody, a family member re-entering your life, all right? You haven't heard from this person. They possibly have been locked up for some, not for all, a few. Or also this person felt jaded, like the family didn't appreciate them or didn't want them around, okay, for whatever reason. They're coming to clear some things up, Virgo. Maybe you invited this person to a party or some sort of ceremony that you were having for a passed on loved one. And they're feeling insecure. They know that this is a family tradition. I feel like they just don't want to come. It could be also for a family reunion here. But they're feeling very, very insecure. Like, I really don't want to go. Excuse me. It's like whatever issues they've had with you, I found out that they've healed on their end. You have possibly healed too, to a certain extent. Okay. But I feel like they want to come back because it's following family tradition, and you were raised like family tradition is everything. No matter what you go through, you show up at their dinner table at such and such a date on such and such a time, you know, so they know they want to be there, but they're feeling so insecure about all of the daggers, all of the things that that they think that people have said about them, you know. But I see reunion here. They're healing here on both ends. I think this death or something that happened in your life as a family, a cohesive unit, it was possibly best for this person to leave. The siblings, I mean, the sibling rivalries or what took place after this person passed away, before they passed away, and during, before this person had finally took their last breath. All right. Somebody left. All right. And you felt like that was the best thing to do. Just go. All right. There could also be some energy here that they're bringing back some things with them. They're going to be very generous. Person possibly hit it big in their life. They possibly made a name for themselves out there doing what they were doing outside of the family unit. I feel they're coming back to get what's rightfully theirs. I have the moon and the water, and I have an attraction. So, you know, I feel like this person is coming back to fight for what they think is theirs. It could be some sort of a jewelry or something, or taking you to court, or somebody in the family to court for some sort of showdown. Like, that doesn't belong to you. That was left to me. Why did you take it? That's not yours. A lot of bickering and fighting amongst family and family members here, close family members and close friends of the family who have grown up around the family forever. I feel like they're coming back to get something, to retrieve something that's theirs. It could be something as silly as a pair of silver wine goblets, or something that was very sentimental to the one that passed away. Y'all fighting over this and it wasn't even yours, okay? Who did she or he leave that item to? You know, coming back, bucking heads with people, getting into an argument about some things. You say this, I say that, you know. So both of you all are thinking the same thing. Both of you all thought that you're going to get that precious heirloom, or you're going to get that money. So it's like, we got to sit down and talk. If she left that money, or he left that money to one person, you know, I feel like this person left with a nest egg. They were sick, you know, they passed away or whatever, you know. I feel like they left a nest egg, and some people didn't get their fair share. Somebody didn't get their fair share, all right? Because you got somebody here who's in the middle, who's supposed to ish it out, what my mother used to say back in the country, ish it out, you know, pass it out to everybody. But somebody was holding on, having more than their fair share. But it was enough to go around. People got very little, if anything. But somebody here got the bulk of that income, the bulk of whatever it is that was left behind. That should have went to everybody, okay? Somebody's pulling the purse strings, okay? Very, very tight. They holding on to money that's unrightfully theirs, okay? I'm hearing they're wrong for that one. They are wrong for that. So, what are these messages? Because this person is coming back into your life, I feel a family member, like I said. You may not even know that something was left. Maybe you are left in the dust about it too, or things are being hidden from you. I feel like a family member knows, and a close family friend knows, and they're holding on to that money so unfairly. They're so unfair here. It's almost, you got to look for things. Look for the clues. They're around there. You possibly read something or saw something that shouldn't be, or reading that fine print. But I have some here that some documents are being hidden, okay? I feel the truth is being hidden, and it's right there in your face. You're not seeing it, all right? You're not seeing it. What's going on with this person's energy who is coming back? I feel like they're coming back to seek the truth, or you need to go back to seek the truth from somebody, okay? Somebody's hiding it, okay? They're hiding it. I have here expectation. I have a wealthy man. This could be the lawyer talking to somebody here, talking to the family, and like, you know, behind your back, talking to somebody behind your back, and you're supposed to be on this conversation too. You're supposed to be on this call to this link, whatever it is. They fail to involve you, all right? Something that's rightfully yours. It could be a family member of, see, it's unclear. They don't want you to know the truth, but I feel like they're talking behind your back, like after the fact, after you left or something. They held something out, they held something back. And the people who, you know, were in control of the funeral or the decision making, they knew everything, but they're not telling. And I feel like you're not the only person in your family. There's two people in particular that know that something is rightfully yours, or it's something that doesn't belong to them. They were supposed to carry it out, but they hooked up with somebody else in a family member, in the family, a family member who's taking everything. You know, you were expecting something. You didn't get what you thought you were going to get. Maybe you wanted the family home or something like that, or wanting something out of the family home that belonged to the person who passed away. That's at the very minimum. You know, what did you get? I have a message of concern. And I have her occupation, followed by community. This person could have talked to the other person holding the money. We got to do something. Maybe they want to start their own company. We'll filter their money down. We'll clean it up, and I'll put it in a business or something like that. You know, they could be faking the funk, like they're paying for a business, doing something to open a business. Where are they getting all that money from? How did they start a business from little or nothing? You know, how did they buy a new car or a new home or invest in this or have enough money to do that all of a sudden? That's because they're taking what's rightfully yours and theirs and everybody else's. I have your official person. I got great fortune. Yeah, I feel like this great fortune is here. It's time to talk to a lawyer, all right? It's time to talk to a lawyer because you deserve some of that. This person worked very hard for this money, this fortune that they created, that could have created some generational wealth for you and your family members, but somebody wants to hold on to it all. You got some, maybe very little, but not as much as you were supposed to receive, supposed to get. You know, even if there was not a clear balance of how much you all were supposed to get, you all should have got everything split down the middle. Okay, no matter how many children or relatives was here, everybody should have got their fair share. But no, you got a trickster in a bunch. All right, see, a thief in a bunch who's taking everything. They give you a very little, not enough. And two, if this is some sort of energy around money that they gave every month or two or three times a year or four times a year or whatever, they're never going to give you your fair share. All right, I feel like they're definitely hiding something to you. They're living the life that you can't afford to live. You got a mature woman, and she ain't saying a word. She got all everything, and you're here suffering. Okay, you're here worried about money. When am I going to get my next lump sum for my auntie, for my uncle, or something like that? I'm here struggling. I'm barely making ends meet, and they got all the money. I can't even call them, and they can't even give me a loan. If they do, they're loaning me money that I have to take less of when they send me my next stipend or monthly payment or something like that. So they sending you the money just in little driplets here and there. Okay, but as long as you're dealing with this issue, as long as you're dealing with this person, you're never going to get your fair share. So you got to take them to court. Okay, there are some papers hidden that you don't know about. Gotta take them to court. It's 11:11. Gotta take them to court. All right, so they can hear your story. There's something that you don't know about. I feel like there's a lot of changes coming here. There could be somebody who's feeling guilty about this. Is going to say, yeah, look, you know, I got some stuff I got to admit to you. I got some stuff I got to tell you. So your mother or your father did leave a certain amount. And I thought that they were going to do right by it, but they didn't. They possibly gave this person something to keep quiet or something like that. But I just feel like a lot of people are on this. You know, sometimes when you have somebody pass away, you don't always know what they have in a bank or saved or something like that. But I feel like somebody knows the truth, the wrongdoing, and they want to tell you, they want to be upfront and honest with you about this. And because you need to, I feel you need to hear this. You need to, you know, dig a little deeper to figure out what's going on here. Because you don't know everything. You don't know everything. When your person passed away, your loved one passed away, they took some things with them out of the house. They were holding on to some paper. Maybe there was something that was written by your loved one, but they weren't going to let anybody see it. Okay. God don't like ugly. They're also with a child who you lost. The child is on the other side. So you had a little girl that passed away. They're on the side. On the other side with the little girl that you lost or a stillborn or an infant on the other side. Yeah, everything changed when this person passed away. See, they're going to blow somebody off the box. This wealthy man here, he should not have all that money. She should not have all that money. And somebody's concerned about you and they're wanting to tell you the truth. They're concerned about the truth not being told, okay, about this amount that should have been yours, but you never got. So I feel like somebody's going to tell the truth. Somebody knows the truth. I feel like I'm hearing some strong energy around a family member and a family, like a friend of the family. This friend of the family could be a best friend of one of your parents or somebody in your house that took care of you. All right. So they made a decision amongst themselves to keep all the money, just give you a little here and there. All right. The treasures or something that you really, really wanted, some sort of memorabilia. But this person is getting ready to be called out. All right. Found out. Let's get a final message. So I feel like the person that's coming into your life, they're coming back to get what's theirs, or you're going back into their life to get to the family fold to get yours. I have conscious consumer. Just watch the way you spend. You already don't have a lot of money right now. Make sure you're curbing your spending, okay? And you live simply and you purchase only items that you really need. Maybe doing some recycling too as well. Obstacles and blocks are being lifted. And I have here moonlighting, maybe having to work more than one job to make ends meet. You wouldn't have to if these people did the right thing and keep their word to the person that passed away, that left you something, all right? Obstacles and blocks are being lifted. All of your good personal work and your positive energy shift has overcome previous obstacles and blocks are lifted away. You will now experience progress and forward movement with your projects. Stay centered in gratitude to ensure that your flow of abundance continues. So when you get this abundance, after you win this lawsuit, or if something is decided out of court, make sure you put their money in the bank and save, and don't go woolly wampus and spend their money all over the place. Don't spend it in one place. Save it. That's what they gave it to you for you can live better. But you had some people in your family, some family friends who hid that from you. They hid the real truth to how much it was supposed to go to you and the people that you loved. It's more than one person involved. And it's more than one person involved and not getting their just due when it came to the family fortune. All right? Talk to you later.